प्रेम से बोलो भगवान रामचंद्र की जय. डिवोटीज, our katha continues tonight. The bhajan also on Swamiji tells us, you know, in katha, we must detach the mind from the, what is temporary, what is maya, what is just here in this mundane planet. He says, detach the mind from the temporary and attach it to what is eternal. What is eternal? Bhagwan. The negative and the positive powers, the shaktis, are both together, will give us the light. He says, plant the seedlings of devotion, namely the preliminary exercise of Nam Smaran, remembering the Lord's name in the mind. We have covered this many, many times, devotees. That will grow into a tree with the branches of virtue, service, sacrifice, love, equanimity, fortitude, and courage. All of the characteristics and the traits of a bhakta. You know, devotees, a good analogy Swami gives us again tonight. He says, you swallow food, but we are not aware how it's transformed into energy. All we think of satisfying the taste buds. How does it get transformed into energy, intelligence, emotions, and health? In the same way, just swallow this food for the spirit, but remember the remembrance of the Lord name, Nama Smaran, that is food, and watch how it gets transmuted into virtues and the rest without you even being aware of it. Nama Smaran, what we are doing tonight on Shivoham, as we have done for the past 55 episodes. You know, a real test of theism. Ravan discovered that Rama and Kama, desire, cannot coexist in the mind. We've done this before, no? Brahma and Kama cannot exist in the mind or the heart. Develop steadiness, Swami says, in the recitation of the name of God and in the worth of that name, the value of that name. Then, even if the whole world says, do evil, you will refuse to obey. Your system itself will revolt against it. And even if the whole world asks you to desist, you will insist on doing what is right. Brothers and sisters, you have cultivated four types of strength into of body, of intellect, of wisdom and conduct. Then you become unshakable. Then you are on the path to spiritual victory. You know, once a person argued that there was no God and he was not prepared to believe in one. Have you heard, have you met people like this? They will tell you, Baba, I don't believe in God. It don't have no God, in colloquialism, right? Well, Swami replied, somebody came up to him and said, you know, Baba, there's no God. He replied, have faith in yourself. Which is yourself? Yourself is God. You have faith in your judgment, your intelligence, and your ability, because God is within you, tells you not to falter or fear. This is so true. That assurance wells from within, devotees. Brothers and sisters, from your basic truth, which is observed, which is otherwise called God. It doesn't matter if you do not call it God. It is enough if you believe in yourself. And once you believe in yourself, that is the real test of theism. Tonight, devotees, similarly, the body is the temple of God. Have you heard this statement before? The body is the temple of God. God is installed in every body, whether the owner of that body recognizes or not. So how can we say there's no God? It is God that inspires us to do good acts, that warns us against what is bad. Listen to that internal voice. How many of us listen to our internal voices that speaks to us and advises us? Obey that voice. Swami tells us, obey that voice and you will not come to any harm. You know, a lady wept that her necklace was lost or stolen. And she searched everywhere. She became so unconsolably sad. Then, when she passed a mirror, she found a lost necklace around her neck. When she looked into the mirror, the necklace was right there all the time. It was there all the time. Similarly, devotees, God is there as the inner dweller, whether you know it or not, whether you can see him or not. And two ways tonight, we cover two ways to remember God's name. One, love. Love is of three kinds. There is self-centered, which is like a bulb. It illumines just a small room. Love which is mutual, which is like the moonlight. It spreads wider, but it's not clearer. And the other is centered, which is like the sunlight. It is all pervasive and clear and powerful. Cultivate a third type of light, like the sunlight, of love, sorry, like the sunlight, and that will save you, devotees. All the service that you do to others through that love is, in fact, service done to yourself. So all of you with hashtag Project Shivoham, remember, I love hashtag Project Shivoham. Type it in.
I love hashtag Project Shivoham. Those of you who have given love in terms of seva, you have helped the poor, you have helped the needy, you have given your groceries and your valuables and your some of you have given clothing items, household items. That is love. You are practicing love. That is love from within. That is seva. No one can take that away from you, devotees. You have already made considerable deposits into your spiritual bank account. Devotees, tonight, it is not others that help you. It is yourself that is helped. Remember this. The repetition, Swami says, the repetition of the Lord's names and its fruits slowly changes character and modifies conduct and mellows. It takes you nearer to God. Remember the story of the sage Valmiki, right? He was a highway robber. And he sat down and he began to meditate. And what was he meditating on? What did he meditate? What did he say? What was his meditation? Mara means to kill. Mara, mara, mara. And if you start reciting mara continuously, several times, what happens? What does it sound like? Let's try it. Mara, 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 mara. It becomes Rama, you see? Mara, 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 mara. This is how devotees, he emerged and he grows and he enhanced himself. He empowered himself to become the sage Sant Valmikiji who wrote one of the episodes of Ramayana. Devotees, well, there are two ways of doing this. Either we do it with a rosary, a mala, japa mala, or turning the beads automatically, of course, around. Just a mechanical and you know, like a punctual way, and as careful as any other routine as act of a day of life. Or, as it ought to be done, repeating the name of God irrespective of the target number. I have to do 108, or I have to do 1,008, I have to do 10,080. No. Irrespective of the target number, dwelling our minds deep on the form instead, it represents on the divine attributes connotated by tasting it, reveling in it, enjoying the context and associations with that name and relishing in its sweetness, Ati Sundaram. Lost in its music. How many times we get lost in music, singing bhajans, tears flow from our eyes, the paws in our hands stand at attention, devotees. You know, of course, you will hanker after the taste of the name only when you are ignored by the fangs of hunger, right? When you suffer from constipation as a consequence of overindulgence in worldly affairs, you cannot relish the name or the form. No, the mind is the mischief maker. Yeah, it jumps from doubt to doubt. If I do this, will this happen? What are the results if I chant 108, 1,008, 10,008? It puts obstacles in the way of the devotees. Swami says it weaves a net and we become entangled in it. Let's not do that. Let us use Shivoham, Chidananda Rupaha, Shivoham, Shivoham. I am formless, I am tasteless, I am odorless, I am Shiva tonight to remove those negativities from our minds so that we can perform Namasmaran, Sattvic in the purest form. Devotees, you know, we become discontented when we have to chant mantras, not so with using the mala. It runs after 100 things away from another 100, 1,000 and so forth. It's like a driver who drives a car with the master in it, wherever his fancy takes him. So take up the task of training now into an obedient servant. It is educable, it is only if you know how to do it. Place before it more tasty things and it will hanker only for those, devotees. What are the results? What are the fruits? What are the merits of our Naam Smaran or devotion? Once it realizes the value of the repetition of the Lord's name, it will adhere to that getting now, the method of getting peace and joy. Let us start it now. Tonight, we sing this beautiful bhajan. Daraji, the late Pandit Hari Om Sharanji, he says in this bhajan, the lyric says, "Awake and chant, O man, O mind, the names of Sita and Ram. By his grace, the birds and Mother Earth awaken at the pre-dawn hours of the day. Life is empty and the human birth is useless without singing his praises, Namasmaran. Suffering is replaced with peace and when we chant his glorious name, Sri Ram is our body, our mind, our life, our benefactor. He who is dear to him shall be liberated. He is the master of the universe and we are his slaves. He who remains awake will enjoy the fruits of happiness and all sorrows will despair. Brightness shall prevail in his life and he shall attain the divine abode." Tonight, devotees, all of us, I'm sure, on this broadcast tonight on Shivoham are intent on attaining the divine abode. Pandit Hari Om, the late Hari Om Sharanji, in this beautiful bhajan, Kahe Sutalabaho, Manva Japalehe, Sita Ram, Sita Ram, as we sing tonight.
Are Kahe Sutalabaho, Manva Japalehe, Sita Ram. Sita Ram, Sita Ram.
Type it into your chat windows, all of you. Say it out loud. Jai Shri Ram. Let us sing.
O kahe su talwaho, kahe su talwaho. Manwa japle Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Sita Ram.
Sing with me, come on.
काहे सु तलवाहो काहे सु तलवाहो मनवा जपले सीताराम 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 राम 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 है हमरा तन मन जीवन राम है हमरे दाता ओ राम है हमरे दाता चिर संगी वो राम रमैया और सभी चुत जाता ओ और सभी चुत जाता वो है स्वामी जगत चैया वो है स्वामी जगत चैया उनके सभी गुलाम काहे सु तलवाहो काहे सु तलवाहो मनवा जपले सीताराम 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 राम राम जो जागे सो ही सुख पावे सोवे दुखिया होए ओ सोए दुखिया होए राम नाम से हो जियारा जो सुमिरन में खोए ओ जो सुमिरन में खोए तेरे शरण हो मेरे मनवा ओम शरण हो मेरे मनवा पाएगा सुख धाम काहे सु तलवाहो काहे सु तलवाहो मनवा जपले सीताराम 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 राम
सिंह
काहे सु तलवाहो काहे सु तलवाहो मनवा जपले सीताराम 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 राम राम ओ काहे सु तलवाहो मनवा जपले सीताराम 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 मनवा जपले सीताराम 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 राम राम मनवा जपले सीताराम 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 राम राम
प्रेम से बल पवन पुत्र हनुमान की जय प्रभु राम चंद्र भगवान की जय To emphasize or to enhance this point, devotees, about Naam Smaran and about worshipping and the fact that God is present in every single one of us, we turn now to Bhagavad Gita. Srimad Bhagavad Gita, chapter 9, verse 16, verses 16 and 17, as Bhagavan Sri Krishna explains now to Arjuna. Prem se bulava ke bindavan bihari lal ki jai Bhagavan uvacha. Radhe, Radhe. अहम् क्रतुर अहम् यज्ञः स्वधाम अहम् औषधम् मंत्रोहम् अहम् ईवाग्यम् अहम् अग्निर अहम् हुतम् पिताहम् अस्यो जगतो माता धाता पितामहः वेद्यम् पवित्रम् ओंकारा
रिक साम यजुर ई वचा प्रेम से बुलवा के वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय. डिवोटीज भगवद गीता भगवान श्री कृष्ण सेज टू अर्जुन इट इज आई हु एम द वैदिक रिचुअल आई एम द सैक्रिफाइस आई एम द ओब्लेशन ऑफर्ड टू द एंसेस्टर्स आई एम द मेडिसिनल हर्ब आई एम द वैदिक मंत्र आई एम द क्लैरिफाइड बटर आई एम द फायर I am the act of offering of this universe. I am the father, he says, Bhagavan Shri Krishna. I am the mother, the sustainer, and the grandizer. I am the purifier. I am the goal of knowledge, the sacred syllable, Om. I am the Rig Veda, Sama Veda, and the Yajur Veda, Bhagavan Shri Krishna. In these verses, Bhagavan Shri Krishna, type into your chat windows, Jai Shri Krishna. Bhagavan Shri Krishna says, in these verses, gives a glimpse into the various aspects of his infinite form. God is omnipresent. He says, personal is infinite personality. Kratu means yajna, sacrifice, such as Agnihotra, yajnas mentioned in the Vedas. It also refers to the yajnas such as Vaishava Deva that are described in the Smriti, in the scriptures. Aushadam refers to the potency in medicinal herbs. Creation, he says, emanates from God, and hence he is Pita, the Father. Before creation, he holds the unmanifested material energy in his womb, and he is so, it is Mata, Mother. He maintains the universe and nourishes it, devotees. He is thus Dhata, the sustainer. He is also the father of Brahma, who is the creator, and hence he is the grandfather of this entire universe. Prem se bulba ke Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki Jai Shri Krishna. The Vedas have emanated from God. The Ramayana states, Jaki Sahaja Swasa Shruti Chari. God manifested in the Vedas by his breath. He manifested the Vedas by breath. They are the knowledge, the potency of God, and hence an aspect of his unlimited personality. Devotees, Shri Krishna states also that this truth is dramatically by stating that he is the Vedas. He is the Vedas, devotees. This beautiful bhajan tonight we sing, dedicated now to Bhakya Vrindavan Bihari Lal. Krishna Rama Govinda. We chant the names of Lord Krishna, Lord Rama, and of course Narayana, the one who attracts and who is all-pervading, the one who protects us and sublimates our tendencies. We extol the Lord with the names of Madhava, Keshava, Panit Keshava is with me tonight, Hari and Narayana, the one who is the master of nature and look bewitching to the lovely locks of dark hair, the one who destroys the hurdles in our spiritual path. Yes, Shri Krishna. We chant the names of the Lord Krishna, Rama, Govinda, Narayana, the one who attracts and who is all-pervading, the one who protects and sublimates our tendencies. We bow tonight reverentially to the Lord who plays the Basuri, the fruit, and who seeks his blessings to become hollow without ego so that he too may use his benevolent instruments. Tonight, I ask you again, Jai Shri Ram, say it out loud, type it into the chat as we sing. Prem se bulwa ke Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki Krishna Rama Govinda Narayana Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki Krishna Rama Govinda Narayana Krishna Rama Govinda Narayana Keshava Madhava Madhava Keshava Hari Narayana Krishna Rama Govinda Narayana Krishna Rama Govinda Narayana Shri Venu Gopal Krishna Shri Venu Gopal Krishna Madhava Madhusudhana Hari Narayana
Rama Govinda Narayana Krishna Rama Govinda Narayana Keshava Madhava Keshava Madhava Hari Narayana Krishna Rama Govinda Narayana Krishna Rama Govinda Narayana Krishna Rama Govinda Narayana
Prem se bolba ke Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki jai Devotees, tonight, heavy philosophy. Now, I'd like you to listen to this part of the Katha. I quote again from Swami. He says, every step towards Godhead is to be cherished. Every step we take towards Godhead must be cherished. Start from today, he says, start a new chapter in your lives. The chapter of recitation of the holy name of meditation, recitation-oriented meditation or meditation-oriented recitation. Whatever name you call him, whether you call him Allah, you call him Christ, Jehovah, Rama, Krishna, Buddha. In the Treta Yuga era, the name was Sitaram. In the Dwapar Yuga, it was Radhesham, Krishna. And in this Kali Yuga, it is Saravanam. That is to say, all the names of the Lord, select anyone that appeals to you. Life is like a flight of steps towards Godhead as we climb these steps tonight. You have your foot on the first step when you were born, and each day is a step that must be climbed. And you know, incidentally, devotees, it is said, Swami says, whenever you take one step towards me, I will take 12 towards you, devotees. So be steady, watchful, and earnest. Don't count the steps ahead or exult over the steps behind. Do not, he says, one step at a time, and that is well climbed. That is enough success to be satisfied with and to give you encouragement for the next one, to make the next step. Do not slide from the step that you have reached. In other words, do not go back. Don't turn backwards. Every step is a victory to be cherished, and every day wasted is a defeat to be ashamed of. Slow and steady, let that be your maxim. Slow and steady. Adhere to a regular routine, devotees, a timed routine. Just as the doctor prescribes a certain fixed amount or measure or weight of the drug and warns you that anything less or anything more may be ineffective or over-effective, and anything more is also harmful, right? So too, have some limits for your spiritual practice or your spiritual exercises, devotees. Swami says, do not overdo them or they will casually cause harm. He says, you also have to repeat the repetition of the name and meditation at regular intervals. Don't do it halfway, in other words. I quote tonight a beautiful shloka, a beautiful couplet from Kabir Das Ji, who speaks now about the meditation announcement and the importance of it. Kabir Das said,
Ram liye jin sab,
Kabir Das Ji ne kaha,
Ram liye jin sab, Ram lila jin sab liya, सब शास्त्रन को भेद राम लिया जिन सब लिया सब शास्त्रन को भेद बिना राम नर के गए पर ही घुनी चारों वेद
कबीर दास जी. He says, one who has realized the eternal imperishable Rama, Ram liya jin sab liya, sab shastan ko bhed, must be considered to have acquired the knowledge of the mystery of all the treaties. Bina Ram narke gaye parhi guni charun ved. And one who could not attain the realization or the mysteries of Lord Rama despite having all and acquired all of the knowledge and all of the certifications of all four Vedas will continue to remain in this life and death circle in this world, which is like narak, which is like hell. Paramahansa Yogananda, I quote tonight, he says, do not be afraid of anything, O man. Even when tossing on a wave in a storm, you are still in the bosom of the ocean. Not so? Always hold on to the consciousness of God's underlying presence. Be even of mind and say, I am fearless. I am made of the substance of God. Say it after me tonight. I am fearless and I am made of the substance of God. I am a spark and fire of the spirit. I am an atom of the cosmic flame. And I am a cell of the vast universal body of the Father. I and my Father are one, so hum. This is what we preach. This is what we practice tonight, devotees.
Do not move away, Swami says, from this, from the very fast with the world. Do not move away very fast from the world. People you see who are always going about in cars and aeroplanes and so forth are people of sedentary habits, which are advised by doctors to take long walks every morning. The walk is called a constitutional because it helps to build up the constitution. What constitution we speak of? Similarly, to get over mental illness, its consequence is on, you know, we brood too long over worldly affairs. The guru will advise you to have some long spell of meditation, not so, and repetition of God's names. When there's a graha, when you are under the effect of a graha, one of the navagrahas, what does the guru tell you? What does the guru, not so, you have to chant certain number of mantras, 12,000, 10,000, 20,000 is the case maybe. That is nama smaran. We don't do it because of the count. We do it because of the effects and the results of chanting nama smaran. We say sarva graha shant, sarva navagraha shanti. Sarve graha shant, as we say, the mantra. Do not move so fast with the world, our Swami tells us tonight. The cure for moving fast is to sit quietly. When was the last time you sat quietly in a corner and just did nothing, absolute nothing? Tune out everything. Do not get entangled in the vain hubbub of the world, as Swami says. The treatment for those who suffer from the after effects of that is silence and meditation, devotees. You will have observed that when you're, for example, you're traveling in a train, your train is stationary. Another train moving along the line gives you the feeling that your train is also moving. Even in your cars, when you're parking or you're backing out from a parking spot and some other car on the other side is moving, you feel that your car is moving very fast. Not so? Devotees, however, if you watch your own car, fix your eyes on your car, you will then know the truth. It's not moving. Similarly, as long as your attention is turned on the other, the outer, your knowledge is based only on illusion. Once you divert that attention to yourself, then and only then you'll be able to discover the truth, viz. Though the world moves, you are still fixed. Be assured that the Lord has come to save the world from calamity, devotees. Your duty is to keep calm and to pray for happiness and prosperity for all. Sarva loka ekanatam, samasta loka sukhino bhavantu. Do not pray for your own exclusive happiness and say, let the rest of the world go into pieces. No, devotees. You cannot be happy when the rest of mankind is unhappy. It doesn't work like that. The formula is not conducive to that. How? You and I are an organic part of this human community. Share our prosperity with others and strive to alleviate the suffering of others. That is our duty, devotees. That is our primary duty. You know, Bhagwan Shri Krishna tells us in this beautiful bhajan tonight, the author, of all the gifts offered to the Lord, true love pleases. It pleases him the most. Love should dwell in us at all times for the Lord, Bhagwan Shri Krishna says. Because of Lord Krishna's love, he discarded the choice offerings of Duryodhan in the palace and went to the poor Vidura, to his home, and partaked on little simple vegetables. Though the fruits were bitten by Shabari Ma, because of her love, it was still accepted lovingly by Bhagwan Sri Ram. And Lord Krishna's love for Arjuna was so great that he forgot in even driving him that he was the divine presence, the divine person. Even in Vrindavan, when the cowherd women sang and danced and made merry for the love, through the love of Lord Krishna, being so proud in the company of the Lord, they were intoxicated by his melodious flute, his Basuri. Surdas, the poet says, a wretched man is unable to even describe the greatness of Bhakti Vrindavan Bihari Lal. Prem se bolo Bhakti Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki. We sing this beautiful bhajan tonight. Sabse uchi prem sajai. Sing with me tonight, devotees. Type into your chat windows, all of you. Say it out loud also. Jai Shri Krishna. Jai Shri Krishna. Jai Shri Krishna. Radhe Radhe. I want you to clap your hands tonight. Come on. Let's build the momentum, build the energy, come on. Jai Shri Krishna, Hari Bol. Radhe, Radhe, sing with me, come on. Bolo.
Sabse uchi.
Bolo.
Prem sajai. Sabse uchi. Prem sajai.
Bolo.
Sabse uchi. Prem sajai. Sabse uchi.
Play those kabasas, play your majira, sing.
Duryodhan ko meva tyage, Duryodhan ke meva tyage, Sag vidur har khai, Sabse uchi,
beautiful,
Sabse uchi, prem sajai,
devotees,
I feel your positivity. I can feel your energy and your love for Bansuriwala. Mohan Murali Aghansham. Let us collectively tonight sing from the bottom of our hearts and the top of our voices with your love. Send this love, channel this love to all those who are sick and suffering, and ask for the blessings of Bhagwan Shri Krishna. Let him play Murali Vale, play that Bhasri, and glorify and purify our minds and bodies and souls. Prem se bolo baake Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki.
Jhoote phal Shivri ke khaye, jhoote,
sing with me,
Shivri ke khaye. बहु विधि प्रेम लगाई
बोलो
सबसे ऊंची रे
हरि बोल
सबसे ऊंची प्रेम सजाई सबसे ऊंची प्रेम सजाई सबसे ऊंची प्रेम सजाई प्रेम की बस अर्जुन रथ हायो प्रेम की बस अर्जुन रथ हायो भूल गए चतुराई
बोलो
ऊंची प्रेम सजाई सबसे ऊंची प्रेम सजाई सबसे ऊंची प्रेम सजाई सबसे ऊंची प्रेम सजाई
सिंह
ऐसी प्रीत करी वृंदावन ऐसी प्रीत करी वृंदावन गोपियन नाच रचाई
बोलो
सबसे ऊंची प्रेम सजाई सबसे ऊंची प्रेम सजाई सबसे ऊंची प्रेम सजाई सबसे ऊंची प्रेम सजाई सुर कौर एक लखे आनाही सुर कौर एही लखे क्या नाही केही विधि करो बड़ाई
बोलो
सबसे ऊंची प्रेम सजाई सबसे ऊंची प्रेम सजाई
बोलो
सिंह सबसे ऊंची प्रेम सजाई सबसे ऊंची प्रेम सजाई सबसे ऊंची प्रेम सजाई सबसे ऊंची
clap your hands about this come on feel the energy Mohan Murali Aghansham he's playing that bansuri through our minds tonight clearing all eight of the major chakras as he blows at the mystical air prem se bolo baake Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki
o Radhe Govinda Gopala jay jay Govinda Radhe Gopala
Hari Bol
Radhe Govinda Gopala Jai Govinda Radhe Gopala Krishna Madhusudana Madhusudana Krishna Krishna Madhusudana Madhusudana Krishna O Shama Govinda Govinda Gopala O Shama Govinda Gopala
Hari Bol
O Radhe Govinda Gopala, Jai Govinda Radhe Gopala, O Radhe Govinda Gopala, Jai Govinda Radhe Gopala, Govinda Govinda Gopala, Govinda Govinda Gopala, O Radhe Govinda Govinda Gopala, O Radhe Govinda Govinda,
Hari Bol,
Krishna Madhusudana. Madhusudana Krishna Krishna Madhusudana Madhusudana Krishna O Shama Govinda Govinda Gopala O Shama Govinda Gopala
Hey Radhe
O Radhe Govinda Gopala Jai Jai Govinda Radhe Gopala O Radhe
Feel the energy, feel the shakti of Basudiwala Bake Vrindavan Bihari Lal Ki Jai Om Shakti.
You see what happens when you practice Namasmaran? Tonight, we have just coagulated all of our energies, all the positive energies of the thousands on this broadcast tonight, all over this planet, in every single continent, to bring together in this virtual establishment, in this virtual environment, this virtual yagshala. And look at the amount of energy. Can you feel it? Can you feel the positivity? Prem se bolva ke Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki jai. May you all be blessed tonight. May we all be blessed. Tonight, devotees, in spiritual matters, experience alone is the deciding factor. Let us see what Swami says here. Reason is rendered dumb before the testimony of actual experience. All the arguments of logic, all the tricks of dialectics are powerless to nullify the direct effect of that inner evidence. For example, take the question of image worship. It's a very, very critical, very, very important subject, very sensitive subject. We as Sanatanists, we worship idols. Yes? And other facets of religion too. Many people laugh at those who practice it and condemn it as superstition, image worship. But those who do worship idols have the faith that the omnipresent Almighty is present in the symbol before them. We as pundits, when we install murtis, we perform something called prana pratishta. Installing or insinuating life into our murtis must be fed, they must be bathed, they must be clothed, they must be artied, and puja has to be performed to them, devotees. We reap the benefits from those. You see, for us, it's not a mere external adjunct or apparatus or an object. No, devotees. It is part of the inner mechanism of devotion and faith. Of course, all the worship carried out with the idea of the idol is lifeless wood or stone or bronze or marble is so much of a waste of time. But if it is done in the full confidence that the image or idol is alive, we speak to the murtis, they are saturated with consciousness and power, then the image, the worship can bestow realization on Godhead itself. Let me ask you a question. I keep asking this on several occasions. When was the last time you had a conversation with God? When was the last time you had a heart-to-heart conversation with God? When was the last time you held on to your murti? You held on to the murti and tears of devotion rolled down your cheeks. Because you believe that your Bhagwan is in front of you. You can feel the vibration. Just as we just felt as we chanted that name of Bhagwan Shri Krishna. Omnipresent. You see, devotees, the spiritual aspirant should not see power inherent in the idol. You may remember the story from a previous Shivoham. I will share it again. A spiritual seeker once approached a guru for guidance, right? We go to the gurus for enlightenment. The guru gave him an idol of Lord Vishnu. Listen to this very, very good analogy from Swami. The guru gave him an idol of Lord Vishnu and also the necessary instructions for daily worship of this idol. You see, but the seeker found that even after some months of meticulous worship, he didn't get any spiritual reward or any sort of elation. So he reported his dissatisfaction to the guru, and the guru gave him another idol, this time of Lord Shiva. And he asked him to go have another try, see what's going to happen. You see, the disciple now came after another 6 months, demanding another idol because he said Lord Shiva had also failed him. This time he got a murti of Mother Durga, which he duly installed in his domestic shrine at home. The two previous idols were standing dust-ridden and neglected, be careful, on the windowsill. And one day, while a ritualistic worship of the goddess Durga was going on, the disciple found that the perfume smoke from the incense stick was being wafted by a breeze towards the idol of Shiva from the windowsill. So the breeze from outside, the wind, was blowing the smoke from the incense, the scent, towards the murti of Lord Shiva. And what did he do? He took a piece of cloth and tied it around the face of Lord Shiva, closing up the nostrils so that he would not be inhaling the perfume or the sweet-smelling incense. And just at that moment, to his immense surprise, Bhagwan Shiva Shankar Bholinath appeared in all his splendor and glory before the seeker. The man was dumbfounded. Why? He did not know how the ill treatment of Lord Shiva by tying up his nostrils would give him darshan. But what he hadn't realized, what had really happened, devotees, you see, the seeker, the devotee for the first time, believed that the Lord Shiva, the idol, was alive, was conscious, was full of flame, Chaitanya, full. And it was that belief which forced him to tie the bandage around the nose of Bhagwan Shiva Shankar. And that's the moment he realized that the idol was full of consciousness, Chitta. He got the realization he was struggling for months. Very, very powerful story indeed. Therefore,
The spiritual aspirant, Swami says, should not see the stone, which the material or the stuff of the idol, but what the power that is inherent within it, that is symbolized by it. That's the same power that is inherent in his own heart and that pervades and the all transcends of all creations. Prem Sibolo Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba Ki Jai Ba Ke Bindravan Bihari Lal Ki Jai Umapati Mahadeva Ki Jai Pavana Putra Hanuman Ki Jai Prabhu Ram Chandra Bhagwan Ki Jai. Devotees,
as we conclude tonight this part of the katha, this beautiful bhajan we sing tonight, a universal bhajan, one of universality. And the reason I chose this bhajan tonight, our katha spoke about Naam Smaran. And we call God, you can call him by any name. Any name he answers. Sarvaloka Ekanatham, in all the universes, he's but one. Many forms, one name. Many names, sorry, one form of God. Many forms and names, one God. Tonight, the bhajan tells us, the chant says this. O universal Lord, we hail you through various names as Buddha, Mahavir, Yeshu, and Sai. Let us chant the name of the formless and attributeless Lord who resides as the supreme preceptor within each one of us. O Lord Sai, you are the supreme teacher and you are the same Allah and Yeshu. O Sai, you are the essence of all scriptures, be it the Bhagavad Gita, the Vedas, or the Qurana. You, O Lord Sai, you are one permeating in every cell of our body, being energized in every bit of our mind. Continue to say, O Sai, you are reverberating in every hair of my body, every inch of my being. Tonight, let us chant the name of the formless and attributeless Lord who resides in this, as the supreme preceptor within each and every one. Tonight, this chorus of this beautiful bhajan tonight, I want you all to sing it. Wahe Guru, bol re manwa. Wahe Guru, bol re manwa. Let us sing.
Buddha Mahavira Yeshu Sai. Buddha Mahavira Yeshu Sai. Wahe Guru Bole Manwa.
Sing.
Wahe Guru Bole Manwa.
Sing with me, come on. Clap your hands.
Buddha Mahavira Yeshu Sai. Buddha Mahavira Yeshu Sai. Wahe Guru Bole Manwa. Wahe Guru Wahe Guru Bole Manwa. Allah Yeshu Satguru Sai. Allah Yeshu Satguru Sai. Gita Ved Quran O Sai. Gita Ved Quran O Sai. Tan me Sai, man me Sai, Rom Rom me Sai Sai.
Bolo, sing.
Wahe Guru Bole Manwa. Wahe Guru Bole Manwa. Wahe Guru Bole Manwa. Wahe Guru Bole Manwa. Buddha Mahavira Yeshu Sai. Wahe Guru Bole Manwa.
Prem se bolo. Prem se bolo baki bindaban bihari lal ki jai. Bhagwan Shri Satya Sai Baba ki jai. Tonight, devotees, it's time for silent sitting on our meditation. Please stay. We have a beautiful story that we will cover with you tonight. And of course, it is time for Growing Pearls of Kindness, our children's series. Tonight, sit comfortably where you are. If you're seated on the floor, please cross your legs. Sit upright. Take a deep breath and relax as you exhale. First, we'll chant 3 ohms and then 21 recitations of Om Namah Shivaya. Breathe in. Om
Oh. Oh. Now, 21 times. Om Namah Shivaya. 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 Tonight, devotees, let a feeling of love grow through your heart and let it spread all through you. I want you to think of someone tonight who you know of whom is ill or hurt, and send this positive love and this collective spirit of healing that is on Shivoham tonight in his virtual Yakshala to them, and let your love spread further and further to everyone. To your parents, siblings tonight, children, I want you to say to your parents and siblings and those around you, I know that God is within me, always with me, everywhere and everything I do. I understand that what I think, what I say, and what I do has an effect on others as well as myself, and that every being needs love and kindness. I will choose to be kind to you and to everyone, to all the animals and plants and to planet Earth, to all the creatures everywhere. Now, I want you to bring your attention back to where you are. Open your eyes, stretch, and smile. Smile with the person next to you. How do you feel? Tonight, devotees, it is time for growing pearls of kindness, but let me tonight welcome back, after having Saturday night off, my youngest son, Pandit Keshav Ji, who is with us tonight. Pandit Ji, welcome back. Say Sitaram to everybody, and he's back with us on Shivoham. Pandit Keshav Ji, God bless you, my son. It is my hope, devotees, that these stories, you know, although geared for children, they are loaded with great teachings and lessons for all. It is my hope that these stories will instill faith in you, in our youth, as well as to remind our youth that they are God's children, that they too are God's children, that we are their earthly guardians, so that they're to be kind and to make a positive difference to this world. Children, how are you going with your growing pearls of kindness at home? Are you growing these pearls every day, helping your parents, your siblings, and the environment? In thoughts, in words, and in actions? Let us listen to this beautiful story tonight. The story's theme, The Devotee Ran Away. Long ago, a clever villager, he used to enter the village temple in the early hours of the day and sit on, with his eyes closed, in the hope that people will honor him as a great devotee. Since he did not get up and go about his business until about midday, it was very difficult for the temple priest, you know, to close the doors of the temple and go home for his daily task that day. So he struck upon a plan to stop this nuisance. He knew that with the closed eye session of dhyana was all a pretense that he was pretending. The temple priest one day hid himself behind the idol of the deity. And when the villager now was well set in his pretense of deep meditation, he said in an imposing, sonorous voice, "Listen, excellent devotee. I am mightily pleased with your asceticism and your steadfastness. Absent earnestness is lacking. Come, I shall merge you into myself." At this, the fellow ran fast out of the temple, leaving no trace of where he had gone to. You see, devotees, the devotion and the sense of surrender of men are similar to those of this imposter. Faith is weak, discipline is absent, and earnestness is lacking. Questions and tonight and personal reflections. How did you feel as you listened to this story tonight? Does this story remind you of anything in your own lives? Can you think of an instance in which God experienced, or which you experienced God's presence? Were you scared or happy or amazed or grateful? Do you have strong faith in God? I am sure you do. Say it out loud tonight. Jai Shri Krishna. Are you disciplined in devotion? Chant Om Namah Shivaya or prayers each day, Tvameva Mahata, and so forth. Speak to God in each day. See God in all each day. Love all, love, serve the needy.
Are you sincere in your spirituality? Is the question tonight. Are you sincere in your spirituality? I am sure you do. Say it out loud. Jai Shri Krishna. Jai Shri Ram. Our learning lessons tonight. You see, devotees, faith is to believe what you do not see. The reward of this faith is to see what you do not believe, Saint Augustine. Success is hastened or delayed by one's habit. It is not your passing inspiration or inspirations or brilliant ideas so much as your everyday mental habits that controls your life, says Paramahansa Yogananda. Pray as though everything depended on God. Work as though everything depended on you, Saint Augustine. Man learns through experience, and the spiritual path is full of different kinds of experiences. He will encounter many difficulties and obstacles, and there are the very experiences that needs to encourage and complete the cleansing process. Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba. Devotees, and in conclusion of our katha tonight, for achieving anything in life, two things are essential: firm faith and pure love. To experience pure divine love, you must be prepared to give up selflessness and self-interest. You must develop purity and steadfastness with firm faith in the divine. You must foster the love of God regardless of all obstacles and ordeals. And you should never think that pleasure and pain are caused by some external forces. Oh no, it is not so. They are the result of our own thoughts. There's no meaning in blaming each other. If you develop the love for God, that love will banish all sorrow and evil tendencies like attachments, anger, and envy. And one should pursue both the spiritual education as well as secular studies. You have to realize that nature is also the manifestation of God. Not so? Yes, devotees. Hence, nature should not be ignored. Nature is the effect of God and the cause. Thus, you should recognize the omnipresence of the divine in the entire cosmos. Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba. Prem se bolo Bhagwan Sri Satya Sai Baba ki jai ho. Add another act of kindness, children, to our growing your pearls, your necklace, your strand of pearls. Please say to everyone on the broadcast and to around you tonight, I love you. Say it out loud. Type it into your chat windows as well. YouTube Live, Facebook Live. Say it out loud. Akashvani, say it out loud. Bhakti TV, say it out loud. I love you. Chidananda Rupaha. Shivoham, Shivoham. Tonight, please share what you have, what you will be taking away from tonight's katha and putting into practice from tonight's discourse. Prem se bolo Mariyada Purushottam Bhagwan Ramachandra ki Jai Umapati Mahadeva ki Jai Baki Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki Jai Bhagwan Shri Ganesh ki Jai Pavana Putra Hanuman ki Jai Devi Mata Durga Mata ki Jai. Prem se bolo Bhagwan Shri Satya Sai Baba ki Jai. Tonight, to everyone that's celebrating their birthdays, their anniversaries, either this past week or this upcoming week, we say to you, happy, happy birthday. Janamdin ko bidhai. To Uncle Vishnu Sukar in Toronto, if you're listening tonight, Uncle G, he is the architect for the Vishnu Mandir on Yonge Street in Markham, and also the Devi Mandir in Pickering. Uncle Vishnu Sukar, happy, happy birthday. Your 74th or 75th, I think you celebrated this past week. Happy birthday to you, Uncle G. And to Uncle Suku of Mahesh Road in Pinal, celebrated his 95th birthday, and he has not yet missed a single episode of Shivoham. From all the members of the Shivoham family tonight, Uncle Suku and Uncle Vishnu, we send our birthday greetings to you. And please join me this coming Sunday, November the 8th, from the hours of 6 to 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time or 5 to 7 p.m. in the Caribbean, Trinidad, Guyana, Suriname, for a special two-hour birthday celebration. We're going to have a birthday satsang. We will sing in bhajans, geets, film songs, Bollywood songs, appropriate Bollywood songs, ghazals, etc. For Srimati Shanti Kisunji of Trinidad, please join me on Sunday, again from Sunday, November 8th, from 6 to 8 p.m. and also from EST and 5 to 7 p.m. AST, which is Trinidad time. Special thank you tonight to Uncle Ram Sukbir of RS Furniture from sponsoring this program from day one, and the other sponsors as well, Auntie Nora Prasad and family, NSP Drug Mart in San Fernando. Thank you all, and to all the other sponsors for sponsoring the programs on Akashvani, and also for the upcoming Diwali celebration. We are celebrating Diwali the following week on the 14th. We'll have Lakshmi Puja. We'll start at 6 p.m. AST, which is 5 p.m. here Eastern Standard Time. And then we will start at 6 o'clock. We will start Shivoham with another Lakshmi Puja to facilitate those in North America. And then we'll have Kirtan, Diwali Bhajans, and we'll be celebrating Diwali on Shivoham on that auspicious day on the 14th of November. Tonight, devotees, I ask all of you to please stand now as we sing final arati tonight. Jai Shiva Omkara. And we give praise and thanks to Bhagwan Shiva Shankar. To all of you tonight on the broadcast, I say thank you. And remember, elections, presidential election results are due tonight here in the United States by perhaps 11 p.m. Hopefully tonight, if there are no anomalies, we should be able to determine who our next president is going to be. And we wish both campaigns all the best. And we pray for the safety. We pray for peace here in the United States, in this beautiful country that we live in this great republic, Democratic Republic here in the United States. Tonight, once again, thank you to all of you. Pandit Keshavji, thank you for sharing your precious time with us. And thank you for accepting the time change. We also wish to thank tonight Swarg HD. Swarg, unfortunately, could not change their timings to the program, so they are not broadcasting us tonight. So we do want to thank them for, from day one, they have broadcasted all 54 episodes of Shivoham. Sharma Ramnarayanji, Hema Ramnarayanji, thank you all so much. May God continue to bless you in the work that you're doing to support Satya Sanatan Vedic Dharma. To all the temple members, to all the temples that support me and I have supported, I say thank you for being on Shivoham. To all of you tonight, Koti Koti Dhanyavad. Let us sing beautiful Jai Shiva Omkara. Om Sajan Chivacha Samayuktam Bahina Yojitam Maya Deepam Grahana Deva Shatrelukyam Timirapaham Yani Kani Chapapani Janmayan Tarkitani Chah Tani Tani Vinashanti Pradakshanama Pade Pade. Sing.
Shiva Omkara Prabhu Jai Shiva Omkara Brahma Vishnu Sadashiva Brahma Vishnu Sadashiva Ardhangi Dhara Om Har 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 Mahadev Ekanand Chaturanand Panchanand Raje O Shiva Panchanan Raje Hansasan Garurasan Hansasan Garurasan Vishwan San Saje Om Har 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 Mahadev Do Bhuj Char Chatur Bhuj दश भुज अति सोहे ओ शिव दज भुज अति सोधे तीनों रूप निरखते त्रिभुवन जन मोहे ओम हर 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 महादेव अक्षमाला वन माला मुंड माला धारी ओ शिव मुंड माला धारी चंदन मृग मद सोहे चंदन मृग मद सोहे भाले शशि धारी ओम हर 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 महादेव श्वेतांबर पीतांबर भागंभर अंगे ओ शिव भागंभर अंगे ब्रह्मादिक सन काडिक ब्रह्मादिक सन काडिक प्रेतादिक संगे ओम हर 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 महादेव कड़मधे कमंडल और त्रिशूल धारी ओ शिवा और त्रिशूल धारी जग करता जग हरता जग पालन करता ओम हर 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 महादेव ब्रह्मा विष्णु सदाशिव जानत अविवेका ओ शिव जानत अविवेका प्रणवाक्षर में सोहे प्रणवाक्षर में सोहे दीनो एका ओम हर 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 महादेव ब्रह्मा विष्णु सदाशिव जानत अविवेका ओ शिव जानत अविवेका प्रणवाक्षर में सोए प्रणवाक्षर में सोए ये तीनों एका ओम हर 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 महादेव त्रिभुवन स्वामी की आरती जो कोई नड़ गावे ओ शिव जो कोई नड़ गावे कहत शिवानंद स्वामी कहत शिवानंद स्वामी मन वांछित फल पावे ओम हर 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 महादेव ओम हर 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 महादेव ओम हर 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 महादेव
प्रेम से बोलो महापति महादेव की जय. Let us sing now. Katha visarjan ho to hai. Suno ho veer Hanuman. Rama Lakshman Janaki. Sada karo kalyan. We sing. Clap your hands, devotees. Sing with me. Come on.
Katha visarjan ho to hai. Suno ho veer Hanuman. Rama Lakshman Janaki. सदा करो कल्याण एक घड़ी आदो घड़ी आदो में पुनिया तुलसी संगत सारे के खटे खोटे अपराध ओ जो जन जहां से आए हो जन जहां से आए हो आ सुनो मंडलाए अपने अपने ध्याम को विदा होत हर शाय सोता सब आसन गए शंभु गए कैलाश रामायण मम हृदय महान आन करहु तुम पार ओ रामा लक्ष्मण जानकी रामा लक्ष्मण जानकी हरत शत्रु हनु भाई कथा विसर्जन हो तू है एक ऐसी शनवाय धन्य घड़ी महायाद की जहा हो टहरि नाम नड़के कौन कलाइए जड़ गई वहां जाए परमं पवित्रम बाबा विभूतिम परमं विचित्रम लीला विभूति परमात्मैष्ठार्थ मोक्ष प्रधातम बाबा विभूति इदमाश्रयामि परमं पवित्रं बाबा विभूति परमं विचित्रं लीला विभूति शिव हरे शिव राम सके प्रभु त्रिविदुता पणिवादन हे विभु आज जनेश्वर यादव पाहि मां शिव हरे विजयं कुरु मे बलम कमल लोचन राम दयानिधि हर गुरु ग्रत रक्षक गोपते शिव तनोभव शंकर पाहि मां शिव हरे विजयं कुरु मे बलम प्रतिदिनं कुशलं जय मंगलं प्रतिदिनं कुशलं जय मंगलं प्रतिदिनं कुशलं जय मंगलं ओ मंगलं भगवान विष्णु मंगलं गरुड़ध्वजः मंगलं पुंडरीकाक्षं मंगलाय तनो हरि ओ समस्त लोकाः सुखिनो भवन्तु समस्त लोकाः सुखिनो भवन्तु समस्त लोका
सुखिनो भवन्तु ओम शांति 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 हरि ओम
प्रेम से बोलो गजानन स्वामी की जय उमापति महादेव की जय सत्य सनातन धर्म की जय प्रभु रामचंद्र भगवान की जय वाके वृंदावन बिहारीलाल की जय पवन पुत्र हनुमान की जय भगवान श्री सत्य साई बाबा की जय जय गुरुदत्ता ओम सत श्री अकाल डिवोटीज टुनाइट
बिफोर वी सिंग आवर फाइनल भजन लेट मी जस्ट से Thank you to all of you who have contributed and donated to Project Shivoham. Type in tonight, hashtag Project Shivoham. I love hashtag Project Shivoham. Many of you have sent in your pictures, your videos, even your stills, your messages that you have donated from your kitchens, from your homes, things that you could have spared, food items, non-perishable food items. So many of you have donated. And tonight I reach out again to each and every one of you. We have many in all different countries, many sources of help. Devotees, anyone listening to this program tonight, if for some reason you are unaware or you do not know where your next mouthful of food is coming from, please reach out to me confidentially. Reach out to me. You can reach out to me by a text message. You can reach out on WhatsApp. Send me a messenger message here. Email on my website. Wherever. Let me know. Even though we cannot help everyone, we will certainly try to connect you with those sources in places who can certainly help. If you are struggling to provide school books for your children to attain their education, also let us know. Devotees, on behalf of Panakeshav and I, Shivoham, Chidananda Rupa, Shivoham, Shivoham. May the blessings of Shambhu, Bhagwan Shiva Shankar, Jai Bholenath, be upon each and every one of you and your families. Please be safe. Remember, please exercise caution, especially tonight, as if you're in the United States, wherever, please don't venture out. Things could get a little heated, but we do pray for a very peaceful election and a peaceful success to our next elected president. We should know here in the next couple of hours. We sing this beautiful bhajan tonight, and I ask all of you to join me for episode Shivoham episode number 56 this coming Saturday, and look forward Saturday, November 7th. And the times again in Trinidad will be on from 7 to 9 p.m. AST, and here in the United States in North America, we are on from 6 to 8 p.m. EST, Eastern Standard Time. Thank you once again. Please, before you leave tonight, share the broadcast, share the feed on your lives, share the live feed on your pages, on your walls, share it amongst friends and relatives, and invite those to join us for the next edition of Shivoham. Prem se bolo Mahapati Mahadeva ki Jai. Let us sing.
Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Har Har Bole. Namah Shivaya Shiva Rameshwara Shiva Rameshwara Har Har Bole Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Har Har Bole Namah Shivaya Shiva Gangadhara Shiva Gangadhara Har Har Bole Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Har Har Bole Namah Shivaya Shiva Jatadhara Shiva Jatadhara Har Har Bole Namah Shivaya Shiva Jatadhara Shiva Jatadhara Har Har Bole Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Har Har Bole Namah Shivaya Shiva Someshwara Shiva Someshwara Har Har Bole Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Har Har Bole Namah Shivaya Shiva Vishveshwara Shiva Vishveshwara Har Har Bole Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Har Har Bole Namah Shivaya Shiva Koteshwara Shiva Koteshwara Har Har Bole Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Har Har Bole Namah Shivaya Shiva Mahakaleshwara Mahakaleshwara Har Har Bole Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya, Har Har Bole, Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Har Har Bole, Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Har Har Bole, Namah Shivaya. Om Dyau Shantir Antarikshagam Shantir Prithvi Shantir Apa Shanti Oshadeva Shanti Vanaspate Shanti Vishwadeva Shanti Brahma Shanti Sarvagam Shanti Om Shanti Deva Shanti Sama Shanti Redhi Om Shanti 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 Hi
प्रेम से बोलो महापति महादेव की जय शिवोहम की जय शिवोहम की जय शिवोहम की जय हो डिवोटीज वंस अगेन थैंक यू ऑल सो वेरी मच लाइक माय पेज ऑन फेसबुक दोस ऑफ यू ऑन फेसबुक लाइव एंड ऑल्सो शेयर योर कमेंट्स विथ मी एज वेल एंड ऑल्सो शेयर द इन्विटेशन अगेन आई प्रे that we will all meet again this coming Saturday by the grace of God for episode Shivoham, episode number 56. We are getting up there, and I hope and pray that we'll continue on this platform to share, to grow, and to enhance, and to enlighten beautiful souls like you all over this planet. Again, Chidananda Rupaha, Shivoham, Shivoham, Om Shanti, 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 Hari Om, Jai Nara.